Hello everyone, I'm Steve from Tamaldon Capital. Today, I want to share with you the topic of plastics. Plastics are extremely versatile materials and are ideal for a wide range of consumers and industrial applications. However, plastic pollution on land is a problem. There is a company that heightens attention toward degradable and biodegradable versions of plastic packaging products. This company is called SCGM Berhad, listed in the year of 2008, stock code 7247. The SCGM's name is formed by taking the alphabet of the four brothers' English names, Sing, Chai, Guan, Ming. SCGM Berhad was established in 1984 through its wholly owned subsidiary, Lee Soon Seng Plastic Industries Tenderan Berhad, and mainly located at Gulai Johor. SCGM Berhad becomes a leading thermoform food and beverage packaging manufacturer in Malaysia. Thermoforming is a manufacturing process where a plastic sheet is heated to a pliable forming temperature, formed to a specific shape in a mold, and trimmed to create a usable product. The sheet is heated in an oven to a high enough temperature that permits it to be stretched into a mold and cooled into a finished shape. Okay, now, let me tell you the reason why SCGM should purchase from now. Number 1. SCGM is grateful for the support from its shareholders despite the challenges faced during the year, and they will always look out for the shareholders' best interest. From its financial highlights and financial statement, its profit is around 80 million per year and is considered stable and consistent. SCGM lost in 2019 because they moved to the new Gulai manufacturing facility after relocations and installation of machinery. It will expand their extrusion capacity of 41 million kg per year to 67.6 million kg per year through their new Gulai factory, which will commission at the end of financial year 2019. Despite its revenue increase in 2019, particularly for food and beverage packaging, however, due to the new plant, operating expenses increased during the year with the operation having yet to reach optimal levels. The average dividend payout ratio over the past 5 years is about 63% per year. Even though SCGM faced loss in 2019, SCGM is still paying out a total dividend of 2.7 cents per share compared to average 6 cents in the past 4 years. According to their dividend policy, Board of Directors of SCGM Berhad is pleased to announce to distribute no less than 40% of the annual net profit of the company to the shareholders. This implies that SCGM tries its best to maximize its profits and pay out the dividend even less. So thanks for the support from its shareholders. Number 2. The new plant in Gulai contributes nearly 65% of its current extrusion capacity of 41 million kg per year to 67.6 million kg per year. Based on the annual report, it will improve the operational efficiency and economies of scale after commissioning of their new plant. In other words, the cost per unit of output decreasing with an increasing amount of output produced. Number 3. In March 2019, they signed a memorandum of agreement with Indonesian food packaging player PT Harapan Infinity Mulia to be the exclusive manufacturer of their degradable food packaging range under the brand name Eco Rasa. The degradable packaging product range includes thermoform lunch boxes, bowls, plates, and trays to be distributed to food and beverage traders, resellers, and retailers across Indonesia. In Malaysia, the government intends to curb the usage of single-use plastic products completely by 2030. To meet the same goal and meet current market demands of reducing carbon footprint, they have introduced a line of degradable plastic packaging products under their Benson and EcoPlus brands. They will also further explore innovations to meet the necessary environment standards. The growth in 2019 was large and caused a surge in sales by 8.1% to 147.1 million compared to 136.1 million in the previous year due to the enforcement of the ban on polystyrene packaging in certain states in Malaysia, as thermoform packaging is seen as an ideal replacement for polystyrene. The ban on polystyrene packaging has also been extended to more states in 2019. Besides, the company is continuing to see the impact of the polystyrene ban in Malaysia, as the regulation now encompasses the whole country. also foresee a similar trend toward neighboring countries in the region as well as other around the globe. This is why SCGM pay more effort to expand their production capacity in anticipation. Number 4. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, this causes a shortage of personal protective equipment. Riding on the sudden surge in demand, SCGM, which specializes in thermoforming food packaging products, has also decided to foray into making protective face shields. The company have received massive orders from hospitals both locally and in Singapore, and even several inquiries from the other parts of the world. The company has ordered a face mask making machine. In mid-April, they started to move face masks into a mass production. They were allocating their resources to a healthcare portfolio as the margins are generally higher than their current ones. Number 5. People's behavior changed because of the COVID-19 pandemic during the MCO. Takeaway demand has surged, which has in turn benefited the company's business. SCGM are the lucky ones, as supermarkets and essential food services are still operation despite MCO. And in fact, the thermoplastic packaging products are mainly servicing these two segments. Not only because of MCO, but the takeaway products demand for food and beverage packaging also continues to rise. New generation people are more likely to buy takeaway or delivery foods. These market trends will create a lot of benefits to SCGM. Number 6. Resin price has fallen due to the oversupply of global producers. The resin makes up 60% of SCGM production costs. This means that it allows the company to benefit immediately from low resin price. Okay, in conclusion, SCGM always places importance on giving back to their shareholders and the environment, and are continually on the lookout at ways to enhance their contributions in these aspects. That's all for our sharing. If you like our video, please like, share, and subscribe to our channel. For more details, please visit our website and link below. Lastly, please remember, trade at your own risk. Thanks, I'm Steve, and see you next time.